All right, we're here for the Wild West Zones Race 2 in the qualifiers. We are at Hungaroring. I managed to qualify P8.
And you as well, Volker.
With a 146.8. Not horrible, but not my best lap either. It is a hotter temperature track than...
good luck, everyone.
I was hoping for, but here we are.
Good luck.
The track temp is 108 Fahrenheit. The air temp is 89 Fahrenheit. We need to follow car number 190 in the left lane. Okay, Chip, get ready. Go, nail it. There's an incident in turn one.
Damn it. So much for a zero incident race. Got nailed from behind myself.
Good start.
Drop back.
B6.
Feel too bad. I seem to be keeping pace. Don't seem to have any handling issues.
Car exit in the pits. 26. Incident in turn 1. Yellow flag, caution. Bad luck, Chip. Come on, don't let him get away.
A little aggressive, considering I was slowing down for a car that crossed my path. Opportunistic, maybe, but...
Shit, come on, make it less shit. V7. Okay, Chip, keep Brandon on the pressure. He'll make a mistake.
I know he's getting away from me, but I'm actually making a tactical decision right now, thinking that after pit stops, tires are going to be at a premium. And if I were mine, I'm going to try to keep up with him, which I probably couldn't get past him right now anyway. Since I'm not necessarily keeping up with him, if I can make my tires last longer by just being a little bit more gentle on them.
Sector 1 is 0.5 off the pace. Behind is catching. The gap's now 2.9 seconds. He's faster than you, entering the chicane. Seventh position. You've got half your fuel left. Sector 3 is 0.38 off the pace. Sector 1 is 0.36 off the pace.
Go right up here, Justin.
Front is now 3.9 seconds. Sector 2 is a second off the pace. Okay, Chip. Pit window open. Just done a 148.09.
Looks like Rosenthal's no longer the one behind me.
Sector 2 is 0.8, off the pace. You've got 10 minutes of fuel remaining.
Go right. Derwin, go right.
To Lacombe behind is now 4.7 seconds.
Thank you.
Ahead is now 4.6 seconds. Sector 3 is 0.34 off the pace. We're halfway through. We estimate 7 minutes of fuel left. Incident in the chicane. Yellow flag.
Go ahead and pass me on the right.
Pack me on the right, Chip.
Voice tight, man. Sorry.
Pit lane speed limit is 50 miles per hour.
Oh, take a Rodney ticket.
Okay, Chip, we'll fuel you to the end of the race. Feet. 100 feet. There's a car approaching. Don't cross the white line. Watch your mirrors. Has now decreased to 8.5 seconds.
Okay, Mark, go on the right.
The car in front is pitting. Okay, Chip, as a car exits in the pits, heads up. Come on, keep digging. E9.
On the right, Joseph.
All right, Chip. 15 minutes left. That's 15 minutes. It's pitting. As the car exits in the pits, heads up. P8.
On your inside, you're 777.
Sector 3 is 1.3 seconds off the pace. Yellow flag, keep your wits about you, mate.
Thanks, Freddy.
Leader is pitting now. The gap in front is now 7.0. Sector 2 is 0.33 off the pace. The gap to Lacombe behind is increasing. It's now 4.1.
On your left, Chris.
Your lap time was 1:48.20.
Go right. Pass me on the right.
Okay, Chip. 10 minutes to go. That's 10 minutes left.
Thank you.
That lap time was 1:48.00.
That's me on the right.
Gap to Black Home behind is now 5.6 seconds. There's an incident in turn 12. Right, Chip, 10 minutes of fuel remaining.
Thank you, Andrew.
Yep, all good.
We think P6 has gone off in turn 14. Yellow flag, caution. Seventh position.
Thank you. This guy is for position on track. However, he's not in the same class as I am. He's in a pro class. So I don't have to work too hard at trying to pass him. I mean, if he makes a mistake or just gives it to me, I'll take it. But he's struggling with his tires right now, looks like. So I had a couple of spots where I could have pounced because I had some pace on him, and I chose not to. Because the percentages just aren't there. Points from me. That would be a different thing entirely.
Left 2 minutes.
Go ahead and pass me on the right up here.
White flag, one more lap.
Pass me on the right here on the straight.
Sector 1 is 0.39 off the pace.
That's on the right. Pass me on the right, Walter. Okay. Pass me on the right.
Thank you. What a race, Logan! Nice racing win.
Oh my gosh. So close.
Dude, you are too much.
P7. There's the checkered flag.
Come on!
Man, maybe two more laps, three more laps, maybe I could have had it, but...
Yeah, you're fast as hell, man. Good stuff. I like the racing. Same from Wild.
Yeah, that's been a lot of fun. Thanks. Wow, you too.
Nice racing, Joseph.
You too, Brian. Have fun.
Enjoy my skin. My spin there, Logan. Shay. Yes, I did. Finally get a pit stop right, and then spin.
Is that what happened?
I might have been a little too happy. Don't worry, I still love you.
It's okay to laugh hard.
Your speed. Box in 950 feet. Feet. 100 feet.
Missed my guy. Oh well. Alright, for everybody just looking to scrub forward to this video to get your sum up-ins, I'll go ahead and jump right into it. Not the prettiest start of a race I've ever seen. There's some definitely some work to be done to get a little bit cleaner racing. But overall, was pretty decent, at least at the front. Justin Tseng in pro won the race tonight. He got the pole position for the entire field and had the fastest lap of a 145.563. On that hot of a track, that's a pretty crazy time. That's really fast. So he got the full 37 point haul for this race. Derwin came in second and Rick Reinsberg came in third. So pro well represented at the front with some similar names, and then Justin joining us for this race, coming out and making a good showing. So also good to see Rodney Campbell back. So Rodney, glad you got your rig together and were able to make it. It wasn't quite the race you had hoped for either. Moving on to club, Logan Grado was one of the cars that passed me early in the race. Had a fast lap 1:07.066. He got pole for club. Pulled in 37 points tonight, so good run by him. Brett Holmes and Brian Granger round out the podium for club class. And in sport, I managed to get the fastest lap At 4 incident points, all because of that first lap incident. Guy behind me lost the rear end, and basically it was like bowling for dollars. Once he lost it, got sideways, hit the guy behind me who got sideways, and then he punted me. I was lucky to hold on to it and go around the outside, find a nice lane that was safe and carry on. Because there were a lot of other people that weren't nearly as lucky, and it was race ending for them. So while I started second, I wound up finishing first in class. So I get a 36 point haul. Joseph Evers, again, second place behind me, and then Matt Bardini finishes out the podium in sport class. Looking at challenge, Todd Rosman and Mark Lacombe and Michael Adams are the podium in challenge. Mark Lacombe, he got pole position for challenge and had the fastest lap at 147.492. So good point haul. So what does this mean for the championship? We now are two races in. We do have a drop race. So this is a six race series with one drop. So we're going ahead and drop the lowest race for participants so that it's just the point haul for the highest race or biggest points haul that they got. So in pro, Derwin Kostanek is in first, Justin's in second, Rick Reindberg in third. And if we go to club, Logan Grado got 37 points, so he's in first place. Volker in second, Austin Buckett in third. And in sport, I got the same in race one, race two, so I'm still at 36 at the top of the board. Joseph Evers behind me and Matt Mardini and Jeff Rosenthal tied for third behind. Of course, we do have tiebreakers that are based on a whole tier of things. It's standard for the competition. It's in the sporting code, I think, for iRacing, how we actually do our tiebreakers, so it's consistent. So I'm not sure if that's already taken into the account in the way that it's been listed here or if it's just merely a matter of who did best tonight. But regardless, Matt and Jeff are currently tied. Challenge. Todd did better tonight than he did last week. So he and Mark Lacombe are tied at the top of the field. And Robert C. Palmer is in third with 32 points. So that's the points as they stand right now. So it's a good, tight field. Some good racing. Some work to be done to just sort of keep us a little bit more consistent and clean on that first lap, turn one. It's so exciting, and it's really easy to make mistakes, I think that that's what happened to a few folks tonight. So we'll work on it and get better as we go as a group. So next race is at Chicago Street Circuit. That's the last race before the holiday break, and then we'll come back. I think we do Monza, Red Bull Ring, and then end up at Indy on the road course there. So it's going to be a fun series. Please do click like, subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. We look forward to you joining us again. Take care. Spaß machen im Sport.